you understand what you're on to.
Mitchell knew?
Of course Mitchell knew.
Woodward! Bernstein! Get in here!
At times, it looked as if it might cost them their jobs.
You guys are about to write a story that says the former attorney general, the highest-ranking law enforcement officer in this country, is a crook.
Their reputations.
Why is the Post trying to do it? I don't know.
Perhaps even their lives.
While I love all genres and all kinds of films to varying degrees, there's something really special to me about the ones that are based on true life, actual events. While films and filmmakers certainly take creative liberties now and then in these biopics or historical dramas, the optimist in me likes to believe that the majority of what I am seeing on screen did actually happen, even if not word for word or action for action necessarily. One of the most enthralling of these types of films is the Academy Award-winning All the President's Men, released in 1976, based on the book of the same name, written by the relentless reporter team of Bob Woodward and Carl Bernstein of the Washington Post, the men who uncovered and published the truth of President Richard Nixon's Watergate scandal in 1972. I was first exposed to this movie in one of my film history classes in college, and I remember from the moment I started watching it, all the way until the end, I was completely hooked. I will say up front, All the President's Men is not for everybody. Some people will not like this style and pace of film and storytelling. It is a thriller without being action-packed, a long and drawn-out journalistic investigation that requires your complete attention and attention to detail. A lot of people do not like these kinds of movies. I, on the other hand, obviously love them. These investigative-type movies really keep me engaged, and every second of the way is gripping. Even when it is a film like this one, where I knew from our history what ended up happening and being published, I still wondered how and if Woodward and Bernstein, portrayed by Robert Redford and Dustin Hoffman respectively, were going to be able to decipher all of the names, all of the clues and hints, and scattered phone conversations and surprise meetings to land the truth. Whether it is a whodunit mystery or a criminal investigation, I love watching this genre of film, trying to follow every step, how they're getting from point A to point B, and eventually to solving the case and delivering the truth. It is even more nail-biting, however, when it is based on a true story like All the President's Men. Those scenes, with the long nights with coffee and cigarettes, the unbuttoning of the sweaty collars, the constant note-taking and going over details, researching files, all until those cheering moments of euphoria, where our heroes uncover something big, or a huge missing piece, to the final chattering of the typewriters as their words go from speculation to fact, to black ink, to headline news. There's nothing like that grimy determination when it is done right. As said before, All the President's Men is not action-packed, but it is far from boring, and it certainly has its moments of tension, such as Bob Woodward's secret liaisons in the shadows with mysterious contact Deep Throat, which leads to the audience wondering if Woodward and Bernstein are being watched, and how, and when, and by whom. Robert Redford and Dustin Hoffman are outstanding in the movie, as they are in nearly everything, and supporting actors like Jason Robards, Jack Warden, and Hal Holbrook fill out the rest of the cast nicely in smaller but sometimes quite significant roles. All the President's Men is a riveting journalistic masterpiece, with an inspiring search to uncover the truth of a massive conspiracy, and it is certainly deserving of the award wins and nominations it received, including Best Picture. The film is primarily dialogue-driven, and while that may scare some people away, it does not make the film any less of an achievement or any less impactful in cinema. If you can do it intelligently, you'll have the audience's interest, which they certainly did and continue to do here. Despite the film being over 2 hours in length, I could have easily watched another hour. I wasn't ready for it to end. And when it does end, boy does it hit it out of the ballpark. It is one of the best political thrillers out there, and even though I am not much into politics myself, I can honestly say I thoroughly enjoyed this movie, enough to watch it over and over again. That is why it has to be included in the list of my 100 favorite movies.
Look, I won't say anything about Haldeman, not ever.
I understand that we wouldn't want you to do that. We know it's against the law for you to say anything. If there's some way you could warn us to hold on the story, we'd appreciate it.
I'd really like to help you, but I can't.
Look, I'm going to count to 10, all right? If there's any reason we should hold on the story, hang up the phone before I get to 10. If the story's all right, you'll just be on the phone after I get to 10, all right?
Hang up, right?
That's right. You got it?
Yeah.
We're straight. All right, I'm going to start counting. Okay? We all right?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
You got it straight now? Everything okay?
Everything's fine.